The Raspberry Pi 2B is a $35 single board computer that makes a great media streaming box for your big screen TV. Simply install Plex Media Server on a spare PC loaded with movies and attach a Pi to each of the TVs in your home for a true multi-room media solution. Although it only uses around 2 watts of power, and it's literally the size of a credit card, here it is alongside my New York City subway card to prove that, it's got a lot of features packed in. So what do you get for your $35? Quite a lot, actually. You get a quad-core ARM CPU running at 900 MHz with a built-in GPU that has hardware-accelerated H.264 decoding and 1 GB of RAM. There are 17 GPIO pins for connecting the Pi to various sensors or other electronic components, and even a connector for a miniature camera board if you fancy building your own security camera. 4 USB 2 ports for connecting a keyboard, mouse, Wi-Fi dongle or additional storage, 1 10100 Ethernet port, it's not gig Ethernet because it's connected via the built-in USB hub, and USB 2 it just isn't up to it. A 3.5mm headphone jack that outputs composite video as well as stereo audio, a full-size HDMI port that can output 1080p at 60Hz, and a micro USB port that is used to provide power to the Pi. Main storage for the OS is a micro SD card slot underneath. If you think the Pi looks rather unfinished as it's a bare circuit board, you're right. For a fully working system, you need a few other items, but most people will have the majority of these lying around. The first thing you'll want to buy is a case. These vary in price from under $5 to upwards of $30. This particular one was around $6 from Amazon. You'll also need a USB charger with a micro USB connector, the kind you get included with most smartphones these days. It needs to be a good quality one. I'd recommend a 2 amp or 10 watt unit with a good thick power cable. A thin cable can cause the voltage to drop. You'll also need a micro SD card for the OS. It needs to be at least 4 gigabytes in size, but as always, the larger the better. And remember, this is the main storage for the Pi, so get a fast one. A class 10 card is recommended. A low capacity card from a quality brand like SanDisk can cost as little as $5 online. This 32GB version was under $15. You'll need to use another computer to actually install the Pi's OS onto the card, so you'll probably need a microSD to SD adapter, and if your computer doesn't have a built-in card reader, some sort of USB one. You can pick up all these items for less than $25 if you need to. Oh, and you'll need some way of controlling the Pi from your couch. You can use the Plex app for your smartphone, buy a small infrared remote and USB receiver, or just use a small USB wireless keyboard with a USB dongle, which is what I do. To install the Plex Media Player software on the Pi, we're going to download a package called Rasplex. Rasplex contains the OS and the Plex software pre-installed, so head over to www.rasplex.com where they have installers for Windows, Mac and Linux. I'm using my Windows PC for this video, so I'll download the Windows client. Run the downloaded software and simply tell it which Raspberry Pi you have, in my case the Raspberry Pi 2, and pick which version of Rasplex you want to install. 1.0.2 was released this morning, but I'll install 1.0.1 for the purpose of this video. If you haven't already downloaded the OS image file, the installer will do it for you. Just press download, tell it where to save it, and a few seconds later, we're golden. I haven't plugged my SD card into the computer yet, but the installer can see my drive E, which is the card reader. I'll just plug the card in, wait for Windows to see it, then press the refresh button on the right, and now it can see my 32GB card. So I just click Write SD card and wait for it to do its job. Okay, now it's finished, I'll eject the card, put it in the slot on the underside of the Pi, put the Pi in the case, and then plug in the HDMI cable, the Ethernet cable, and the keyboard. Don't plug the power cable in until everything else is ready, as the Pi will immediately try and boot as it has no on-off switch. The first thing Rasplex does on booting is resize the SD card's disk partition to use the full space available on the card, then it'll reboot. And now we just run through the installer by hitting next. The first thing we need to do is make sure the Pi is on the network, which it is, so we hit next again. So if I choose Do Calibrate Here, we can now use the arrow keys to set where the top left corner should be, followed by the lower right, and how high up we'd like our subtitles to be. Just press Escape when you're done. If you have the Pi plugged into your TV, this is worth doing, as most TVs use something called overscan, where they stretch the picture past the borders of the screen, cutting off the edges of the picture. Now we log the Pi into the MyPlex website. This is optional, you can just manually enter in your Plex server's IP address, but I think MyPlex is a great service as it lets me see the Plex servers of my friends and stream movies from them. So I'm going to log in here. I also need to log into MyPlex on my PC as well, and then go to myplex.tv/pin and enter these digits there, which will automatically log the Pi in. All done. So the final step is to run the pre-caching option. Pre-caching lets the Pi download all the movie artwork thumbnails from your server in order to speed up the user interface when you're scrolling through your movie collection. I highly recommend doing it. It makes Plex much more pleasant to use on the Pi. It'll take a few minutes to run, so I'll just cut to the end here. And then from here on in, it's standard Plex stuff. You can scroll through a whole screen of thumbnails fairly quickly, certainly much more responsive than the app on my smart TV. Let's take a look at the documentary section and here play one just so you can see the performance. This is a 720p file, but the experience in 1080p is just as smooth. So there you go. Probably the cheapest way to get Plex onto your TV, both in terms of upfront cost and electricity consumption. It's just one practical use for this impressive little machine. Like this video and subscribe if you'd like to see more how-tos and things that you can do with a Raspberry Pi.